often you need to work on a document with others. In Word 2013, you can be much more efficient in your collaboration by co-authoring the document in real time. You can also access the document from anywhere and edit it on any device using the Word web app. Let me show you.
Here's a document that I'm working on with two of my colleagues. Ideally, we would all sit down in the same room and work on it together. But since we're not all physically in the same place, we're going to co-author this document remotely online. To co-author a document with others, you need to save the document to a OneDrive or SharePoint folder. Click File, Save, and then select the location. Here, I'll select my OneDrive Business folder. This way, the document is saved to the cloud, but I also have a local copy of the document synchronized on my laptop so that I can work on it even when I'm offline.
Hi, I'm so sorry to interrupt. I just wanted to let you know that if you're annoyed by the ads in this video, you can access our tutorials ad-free by getting a subscription to businessproductivity.com or signing up for one of our many courses on platforms such as Udemy, CyberU, and Vimeo On Demand. I also wanted to take this opportunity to tell you a bit more about Storyals. Storyals, which stands for Story-Based Tutorials, is our video package offering for organizations that want to increase employee productivity using Office 365. With Storyals, organizations can inspire, motivate, and educate users on effective use of Office 365 by showcasing real-life best practices. Finally, I want to encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channels, Business Productivity and Storyals. Here you will also find my video blog, Succeed in the Digital Workplace, as well as other videos that can help you increase your productivity. If you have any questions or comments, please post them here and I'll do my very best to get back to you. With that, let's go back to the tutorial. Thank you for watching.
Next, you need to share the document with the people you want to co-author the document with. Click Share and then Invite People. Here, I'll add Nora and Jacob, whom I'm working on the document with. You can decide if they should have read-only access or editing access. To co-author the document, they need to have editing rights, so leave the default, which is Can Edit. Here, I'll write a personalized message that will be included in the email. To start sharing, click Share. An email is sent out with a link to the document. Here you can see that the document has been successfully shared with Jacob and Nora. I'll click Back to go back to my document. When you've saved a document to shared location, you can see that the Save icon looks a bit different. By clicking the Save button, not only do you save your own changes, you also refresh the document and synchronize any changes that other authors might have done to the document. When multiple people are working on the same document, it's very useful to use version control so that you can roll back to an earlier version of the document if you want to. Version control is turned on by default on this SharePoint document library. To check the version settings in SharePoint, click the File tab. At the bottom right corner of the Info section, click Open File Location. Now, the SharePoint document library opens up in my browser. To check the versioning settings, click Library, Library Settings, and then Versioning Settings. Here you can see that version control is turned on and that major versions are being saved automatically for this document library. You can also see that checkout is not required since we want multiple people to be able to edit the document at the same time. I'll click Cancel here and close down the library settings and go back to the document. Let's switch over to Nora to see what this looks like for her. Nora is traveling. She's logged into Office 365 via the browser on a temporary computer. Here she sees the email with a link to the document. She clicks the link to open up the document. The document opens up in the browser using the web app Word Online. To edit the document, she clicks Edit Document and selects to edit in Word Online. The document opens up with the editing tools activated in the browser. She gets a notification that I'm currently editing the document. At the same time, Jacob opens up the link to the document in the browser on his iPad. He selects to edit the document using Word. The document opens up, and now he can edit the document on his iPad using the Word app for iPad. When I refresh the document in Word, I get a notification that two other authors are editing the document. If I click the little people icon in the status bar, I can see that both Nora and Jacob are editing the document. I can see from their green color status that they're online and available using the real-time communication platform link. Using a real-time communication platform like Link or Skype, you can easily communicate with your co-authors. When I hover over Nora's name, the link quick bar opens up, and here I can easily select between different ways of communicating with her. Here, I'll click the instant message icon and send a message to Nora, asking her to write a 100-word introduction. I can immediately see from Nora's reply that she's okay with that. Now, I want to send a message to Jacob as well. So to include him into the conversation, I'll click the participant icon and then invite more people. I'll write Jacob's name and select to add him to the conversation as well. Now I can send a message to both of them asking if they can make the deadline by 12 p.m. I'm happy to see from their responses that they're both okay with the deadline. I'll thank them and then minimize the link communication window. Let's see what happens when Nora starts writing text into the document. You can see Nora's screen in the top right corner. As soon as Nora starts editing the text, I can see in my document that the paragraph is marked with a gray line and her name. The section is locked for editing, so when I try to change something, I get a message that modifications are not allowed since the section is locked. To the right, in the status bar, I can see that updates are available. I'm also notified that updates are available if I hover over the locked section. If I scroll down a bit, I can see that Jacob's editing another section of the paragraph, but there are no updates available yet. To update the document, click the Save button. I get a message telling me that changes are marked with green overlay. The green color is only shown momentarily to highlight the changes made by other authors. It does not appear when you print the document, and the next time the document is saved, it disappears. Here, I can clearly see the changes that Nora has made to the document. After a while, I can see in the status bar that more updates are available, so I'll click the Save button again to refresh the document. Here, I'll mark the option not to show the information window again and click OK. The green color from Nora's section disappears, while the section Jacob has been editing is highlighted. Even though it's unlikely, multiple people might start editing the same section at the exact same time. Or someone might work on the section while they're offline. Let's see how Word manages these situations. I'll go to the very end of the document by pressing Ctrl+End on my keyboard. Now, I'll start adding some text to the closing paragraph. In the top right corner, you can see Nora's screen. At the exact same time as I'm editing the closing text, Nora is making changes to the same section. Since Nora is using Word Online, her changes are made to the server document immediately. When I save the document, I get a notification that my changes conflict with updates made by someone else. As you can see, my document has been updated with the changes Nora has made to the document, but her text has mixed with mine. I'll click Resolve to manage this conflict. When you click Resolve, the Conflict tab opens up. Here, Word tracks the changes, and I can select to accept or reject the changes I've made. In some instances, I prefer the wording Nora has used, so I'll reject what I wrote and keep her text. In other places, I want to keep my text, so I'll walk through the paragraph, resolving the conflicting text. When I'm happy with the changes, I'll click Save and Close View, and then close the Conflicts tab. I'll click Save again, and this time my changes are saved to the server copy without any warnings. Now I've gone through the entire document, and I'm happy about the changes we made together as a team. If, however, I need to go back to a previous version of this document, I can always do that thanks to the version control. To see earlier versions of the document, click File, Manage Versions, and then Refresh Server Version List to make sure you have all of the latest versions. Mark the version you want to open. Here, I'll open the very first document I first uploaded to the server. To restore this version, click Restore. But in this case, I'm very happy with the current version, so I'll just close down this version and go back to the current version of the document. By working on this document together as a team and co-authoring it from various locations and devices, we were able to successfully meet our deadline.